All right, a few more questions. Let me see. After graduating high school, Mom, where did you go? What did you do?
I worked for the Singer Sewing Company in Wausau.
Singer Sewing Company, okay.
They taught sewing classes.
Oh, wow. Did you start as a teacher, or did you...
Well, I worked there. I was a clerk there. I just had a job.
Mm-hmm. And then they knew you were a really good seamstress, and they got you teaching. Oh, okay, that's great. Dad, what did you do after graduating high school?
Go to college.
What college?
For Wittenberg in Springfield, Ohio, on a scholarship. And when the war broke out that December, 1st December of the semester, they let us finish the semester before you reported to the draft, which was a couple more months.
So you were born in 24, so you were, when you turned 18, it was 1942.
It was 1941, December 7th, when we were coming home with a Salvation Army brass sextet. We played at the prison and the boys' industrial school. It was like a reformatory, boys' reformatory. Turned on the radio on the way home, which was 60 miles away. They said Pearl Harbor has been bombed this morning. And that would be December 7th, 1941.
Right, okay. So that was your first stint in the Army before you became a doctor. Of course, you were 18.
Yeah. Okay.
And what were you in the Army?
Well, I was in the 13th Port Battalion Company that would fix harbors after the Army took over, like in Sicily in Italy. But fortunately, I got called if I want to take a test for going to the Army school program just before they left, so I never went overseas.
Oh.
So then I was placed in engineering in the Army at Syracuse University.
Okay.
So
the Army Engineering Corps.
Right. Well, that was engineering schooling.
Mm-hmm.
But the first 2 years, our semesters were 3 months, and the first 2 years was almost identical to pre-med. And when I got back from a seven-day leave, at the end of, I was told to report over to another building, and I said, "What is this?" They were giving a talk in the amphitheater. A guy leaned over and said, "This is a new pre-dental pre-med class." So I got in the Army pre-med class.
Oh, wow. That's great. Yeah, that's nice. So, all right. So now, after college, when and where did you meet each other?
Well, it would be in Wausau. At a young people's gathering.
It was Wausau Assembly.
Yeah.
In 1951.
So, Mom, you were 21, right?
Mm-hmm.
And Dad, you were 27.
28, I think it was.
Mm-hmm. And so you were the
Wausau. Well, no, I was younger. I was younger than that. I would be
26.
25.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
25.
So what was your first impression of each other when you first saw each other?
Well, I thought he came through our young people's group. And I thought he was pretty smart. He was a doctor. there wasn't anybody else in the medical field in our family, really.
Yeah.
And I drove Ellen home after the meeting, mm-hmm. because I worked for some doctors there, and they lent me a car. I didn't have my car, my own car. So we always drove her and her mother home.
Mm-hmm, because we never had a car. My dad never owned a car. So to ride in a car was special.
Yeah. Yeah. And so how long was the courtship before you decided to start dating? Or how long was the courting process?
I don't really remember.
Well, I don't think we went together in young people's meetings, but then around the 25th of June or September was the first, actually as far as agreeing to get married was within 2 months.
Mm-hmm. Oh, wow. Within 2 months of meeting each other?
No.
Because
we had been going to the meetings since September 51. Mm-hmm. But as far as going together, probably wasn't until June 52.
Oh, okay. So it was a little bit of time there.
Yeah, and then, but then we got married in August.
So August 1952.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Wow.
I was born 1955. That's all I know.
Okay, so let me see. Were you surprised when Dad proposed to you?
Well, there was some kind of an understanding, I think, in our relationship that we were meant to be together, mm-hmm. in the Lord's plan, I guess. Here we are. It's for real.
Yeah, 60-some, 70-some years, 70 years later? 76?
52 we got married.
76 years? No, 66.
Yeah.
66 years later. Wow. Yeah.
And 3 months later, we were headed for Montgomery on the draft notice from the Air Force, which was unconstitutional, but they made the draft age. I was 29. The draft age was 28. Mm. But for doctors, veterinarians, and dentists, it was up to age 50.
Right. All right. So, where have you lived from when you first got married? What cities and states have you lived in?
Wow.
Has it always been Wisconsin?
Except for the 2 months training in Alabama.
Okay. Oh, in Montgomery, Alabama. Mm-hmm.
For the Air Force Base. Mm-hmm. We became a 60-day wonder officer. It was ridiculous.
So you went to Montgomery for 2 months just after you got married?
Well, yeah, in November.
Okay.
And we got married in August, and it was November.
Okay. And then?
And then we went to California for a week or two. That's just induction for shipping out.
Right.
And then she drove our car back by herself 2 months after she got her license.
How I ever did that.
We didn't know whether we should sell the car or not, and she decided to keep it.
I picked up a lady in Minneapolis.
But she drove so
a
bad.
A hitchhiker?
No.
No, somebody from in connection with
from the meeting.
Oh,
in San Diego.
Yeah.
But she drove so poorly, Ellen wouldn't let her drive.
No.
Hardly.
I'm alive.
And it was winter.
Yeah.
Wow.
So she drove back to Warsaw with our Hudson, used Hudson we bought.
Wow. It was a 1940s Hudson?
It probably was 49 or whatever.
And how old was Mom then? About 25?
No.
And she drove the car back.
Well, she was 21 or 2.
Yeah, 21.
She just had her license 2 months. And she could have flown back, sold the car.
Yeah.
Decided to keep it.
Yeah.
It was a Hudson. It was just painted. We couldn't get the car the day before we were married because the paint wasn't dry.
Mm.
But they picked it up the day we were married.
Wow.
My dad picked it up.
Wow. All right. So what were your first few years of marriage like?
Heaven on earth. That's all I will say.
A couple years before kids came along, right? Or was it, no, when did Ruth come along?
Well, no, we had, when I came back from Korea, we were stationed at Wyoming Air Force Base.
Oh.
For how long?
6 months. And I was sitting at my desk. I was on OBGYN. Sergeant tapped me on the shoulder, said, you know, you can get out early. You're supposed to be in for 2 years. It was a year and a half. He said, but we have to know in 3 days, you got to make the decision.
Hmm.
And you can get out or stay. I thought I'll stay for internal medicine, which I was interested in. Then it'll be May to November, and we can get in to see the Tetons and different things which were closed during the winter.
Hmm.
And we went home, turned the radio on, and they had just declared war on Israel, Egypt, and we said, we better get out.
Yeah, don't want to be traveling over there. Yeah. Wow.
So then after that, we came to Warsaw, and we just moved shortly after to Antigo to open up an office.
Okay.
I had an agreement with the doctors I wouldn't set up my own office within 10 miles of the Warsaw city limits.
Mm.
I don't think they would have held me to it.
Right.
But we came over here.
Okay. So it was Alabama, it was Wyoming, and Wausau, and Antigo.
Right.
Okay. All right. So when did Ruth come along? It's 1953?
I
was 55, so she was 54.
Well, she would be 50, because you were pretty close.
She
was badly sunburned when she was pregnant. We went to Jones Beach in New York.
Oh, yeah.
On Long Island Sound. Then we went camping up in the at the Three Lakes or Five Lakes, whatever it was, up there for a week.
I think she must have been born in 53.
And, of course, then when she came back, she went to the Warsaw had only one obstetrician in the whole county, and she went to him, Dr. Schroth.
She was born in October, and then I was born the next December, so, I suppose it was 53.
So we came here in 1954 in August. Started and opened up the office, and she had the baby 3 months, 2 months later, or September.
Oh, so it must have been 54, and then I was 55. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
54, yeah.
All right, just a couple more questions, and then I'll let you go. We'll probably do this get together again for a little bit, a few more questions, but this will be good for today. So how many houses have you lived in Antigo? Before you came here,
rented two.
Rented
2nd Avenue to Eva Jewell's 1333 place, and then we bought this place.
And bought this one, okay.
So those other places, we might have lived a year.
Isn't her address 1333?
What?
Hmm? We came in 54 August.
Carla's address is.
And in 57.
That's ours.
1333?
Mm-hmm. South Commercial Street.
1333.
You lived at 1333?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Well,
And in 50, and in 57, well, that was a, the lady was a,
I heard that somewhere.
A million, either a millionaire or half a millionaire, and not honest.
Ah.
I mean, she was very tricky.
Yeah, she sure was.
She owned the Cadillac thing when tires were rationed during the war.
Yeah.
Somebody told, she has a great big basement, the whole thing up to the front, was stacked to the ceiling with tires.
Mm-hmm. Wow.
And if you could believe it, she had the Cadillac garage, and she, but all the cars in the parking lot, she sold them all, as is. And after it was settled, now if you can believe this, I don't, one car had no engine. I mean, she was very tricky.
Wow. All right. Well, thanks so much. There's so many more questions, but this is good for now.